Hello, very good morning and welcome to other newspaper highlights. Today is Saturday, 13th of May 2017. This is Edward with the highlights of today's English newspapers. Daily Mirror, Daily News and Ceylon Today are taken up for today's highlights. The main headline of the Daily Mirror highlights: Parliament membership. Supreme Court stays appeal court ruling on Geeta. Her appeal to be supported on May 15. She filed it in the Supreme Court on May 9. Unseated on basis of her dual citizenship. The Supreme Court yesterday issued an interim order till Monday, staying the operation of the Court of Appeal order disqualifying Galle District UPFA MP Geeta Kumar Singh from being a Member of Parliament on the basis that she was a dual citizen. New bill will allow displaced people living abroad to vote. The government is known to be preparing legislation which, if enacted, will enable persons displaced prior to 2009 and living abroad to vote at elections despite their names not being included in the electoral registers. Modi assures 10,000 more houses for upcountry Tamils. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi yesterday hailed the spirit of Tamils of Indian origin living in Sri Lanka and announced the construction of an additional 10,000 houses in upcountry areas and the extension of the emergency ambulance service. Modi meets MR and Gota. Visiting Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi is reported to have taken time off from his busy schedule to meet former President Mahinda Rajapaksa, his brother, former Defence Secretary Gotabaya Rajapaksa and former Foreign Affairs Minister G.L. Pierce soon after his arrival in the country. Secondly, let's move to Daily News. Indian PM Modi promises another 10,000 houses for plantation sector. Extension of 1990 Indian ambulance service to rest of the country. Air India starts Colombo to Varanasi flight for Hindu devotees. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi yesterday assured 10,000 more houses to the plantation sector and the extension of the 1990 Indian ambulance service to the rest of the country, as he promised the Tamils of Indian origin community that India would continue to be a part of the onward journey of Tamils of Indian origin and work tirelessly along with the Sri Lankan government towards their social upliftment in all possible ways. Air India has also started a direct flight from Colombo to Varanasi in India to make it easier for Hindu devotees seeking pilgrimage there, the Indian Prime Minister said. Strong Indo-Lanka ties nurtured by Buddhism, says President. President Maithripala Sirisena said that Buddhism has helped strengthen ties between Sri Lanka and India. The President added that Theravada Buddhism brings many solutions for social, economic and political woes nationally and internationally. Finally, let's move to Ceylon Today. Modi encouraged by talks with Sirisena Radil, poised to scale up cooperation with Sri Lanka. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi, who arrived in Colombo Thursday to take part as the chief guest at Sri Lanka's UN Vesak Day celebrations, brought with him a bag full of goodies, reiterating that India and Sri Lanka shares a deep Buddhist heritage. He said the two countries can step towards the future together, adding that with effect from August this year, Air India will operate direct flights between Colombo and Varanasi to ease travel to the land of the Buddha. He also declared 700 scholarships a year for study under the Ceylon Estate Workers Education Trust that was established in 1974. He also pledged to establish a vocational training center, 10 engineering training centers and laboratories to impart appropriate skills in addition to computer and school labs in plantation schools. JVP flees government. Sri Lanka abstains from UNESCO vote. Sri Lanka has abstained from voting with the resolution brought by UNESCO against the destruction being carried out by Israel in the old city of Eastern Jerusalem, which has been named as a World Heritage Site. Unscheduled one-on-one Modi-MR in late-night talks. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi had met former President Mahinda Rajapaksa in Colombo in an apparently unscheduled late-night meeting on Thursday. Indian High Commissioner to Sri Lanka, Taranjit Singh Sandhu told reporters the meeting was at the ex-president's request. With that, let's come to an end of today's paper highlights. We will come with more news tomorrow morning. Thanks for listening to Adhava News Paper Highlights.